It's wrong to kill an innocent person, but is it always wrong? Are there some moral rules that should never be broken? Or is morality ultimately about doing whatever has the best consequences, even if that means breaking the supposed rules? There are two approaches to moral theory that answer these questions very differently. According to consequentialism, morality is ultimately about doing whatever has the best consequences. But according to deontology, there are certain moral rules that should never be broken. How do we decide which theory is better? One thing we can do is think about specific cases and see which view they seem to support. Thanks to philosophers Philippa and Judith Jarvis-Thomson, we have some interesting cases to think about. First, let's consider the trolley problem. Imagine a runaway trolley was hurtling down a track. On the track ahead, there are five people who are about to be struck and killed by the trolley. Fortunately, there's a fork in the track ahead, and you happen to be standing right next to the rail switch. If you flip the switch, the trolley will be diverted to the other track, and the five people will be saved. But there's a catch. Another person is on the other track. So by diverting the trolley and saving the five people, you'll be killing an innocent person. Should you pull the lever and kill one to save five? This is a tough question, but most people say that the right thing to do is to pull the lever. Why? Well, it has the better consequence. It's better that five live and one dies, rather than one lives and five dies. So this case seems to support consequentialism. It seems okay to kill an innocent person if doing so would have a good enough outcome. But now consider a different case. Imagine you're the world's greatest surgeon, and you have five patients with organ failure. If they do not get transplants today, they'll die. You also have another patient. He came in for his yearly checkup, and as luck would have it, it turns out he's a perfect match for your five dying patients. You realize that you could kill this patient and use his organs to save your five other patients. Should you do it? Of course not. This appears to be a case where you should not kill one in order to save five. So this seems to support deontology. It appears that there are some moral rules that you should never break, even if doing so would result in more lives saved. We've barely scratched the surface of how to understand these different approaches to moral theory, and there are many different nuanced versions of consequentialism and deontology, and there are other moral theories as well. But for now, if you think that morality is ultimately about doing whatever produces the best outcome, you might be a consequentialist. And if you think that there are some moral rules that should never be broken, regardless of the outcome, then you might be a deontologist.